So what's up? I'm doing another episode of Stone Psychology. So today we're going to be talking about the unconscious and a powerful weapon that I've developed with somebody else that basically it's called the thought tax, and it preys upon the fact that our unconscious mind sees things in ways that our conscious mind does absolutely not. So with that being said, let me get into this. Here we go. Blaze up, bitches. So So working crisis, I speak with a lot of depressed people. So one thing you could do to really annoy a depressed person is basically tell them to just cheer up, okay? So that's definitely the number one way to upset a depressed person. And this, what I'm about to tell you guys, is basically, it's what, when I talk to people that are depressed, they tell me this is something that actually makes sense. This is the one piece of advice that has really helped them over like an echelon of such bad suggestions. So with that being said, what I've coined the term is thought tax. So it's a very simple facet. All you got to do is think two good thoughts for one bad thought. So it's natural for the human mind to basically be stressed out, to look for things that are bad even. So with that being said, you need to reprogram your unconscious mind in order to make this work. And this is in psychology what's called reinforcement. So you're going to need a lot of reinforcement to make this process actually profitable in the long run. Or profitable, beneficial. So with that being said, these are playing off of a lot of Freudian theories, a lot of Jung's theories. So the unconscious mind, we tend to subtext our language in our mind. We tend to vocalize in our mind, and that's not really how the unconscious works. That's not the best way to receive information in the unconscious mind. And this thought tax, it's basically just exactly that, a tax. So it's not just about saying two good things for one bad. It's about thinking, visualizing two good things for every one bad. Does that make sense? So let me try to think of an example. Let's say you just fucking, maybe you just got divorced or some shit, and you could sit there and think, oh man, I'm not good enough, man, what the fuck? Or you could sit there and you could think, you know what, I can find somebody better, okay? I can become a better person. And the way you start taking that information in, I think at about 19 days is as much as neuroplasticity takes to generally form after constant reinforcement. So with that being said, next time you think about thinking a bad thought or thinking something, or you maybe have habitual thinking that is just a negative thought pattern, depression, be very careful with that, especially self-diagnosis. You do not want a self-diagnosis of depression and all that. You definitely can use this as a tool, a very powerful tool, to keep in your arsenal of positivity. So with that being said, let me just review. It's a thought tax. That's what I call it. That's what I've coined it. This technique isn't new, okay? But it is, this is my little project. Anyways, of kind of expanding upon that. So with that being said, two good thoughts for every one bad. If you want to spread that, if somebody's depressed, maybe it's better to tell them that as opposed to, oh man, just cheer up, dude. Just cheer up. Depressed people do not like that, from what I found. So hopefully this little bit of stone psychology helped you out a bit. Be positive and help people out.